Here in Philadelphia, Citizens Bank Park, we've got a perfect night for baseball on the show. It's the Los Angeles Dodgers taking on the Philadelphia Phillies. With my partner, Chris Singleton, I'm John Ciambi. And Siggy, here in Philadelphia, the hometown fans are excited.
This is one of the best places to play when you're playing well. No one more passionate than these Philadelphia Phillies fans. And this ballpark's still one of the most beautiful parks in all of baseball.
First pitch coming your way next. Just about set to go now. And today on the hill, Zach Wheeler. How about a scouting report on him?
Well, he comes at hitters with a five-pitch mix. So for him, it's always interesting to see how he utilizes those weapons. He may lean on one or two pitches depending on how things are going and how things are working. But if he can control four or even five of those offerings, look out, hitters. It's going to be a tough day. He's really going to be able to keep those guys off balance.
And now here's the Dodgers' designated hitter, Shohei Ohtani.
He's a bad ball hitter, so even if you get him to chase pitches outside the zone, he still might beat you. Not an easy out by any means.
The wind of the pitch. And another ball.
Three balls, two strikes.
This one popped up. Foul ground, first base side. One away. Time now for Dave Roberts' lineup for the Los Angeles Dodgers. They're dealing with a top-level arm on the mound, so this figures to be a tough matchup for them. What's the key to the offense today, Singy?
Oh, Boog, I think when you got a guy that's this talented on the mound, you got to find ways to disrupt his rhythm, make him uncomfortable a little bit. The guys that can handle the bat and perhaps, you know, bunt for a base hit, get him moving off the mound. If you're in the box and he seems to be just in a flow, step out, mess up his timing, somehow try to get in his head a little bit. And then when he does come in the zone, you may only get one pitch. You better not miss it.
One down, base is empty. Sit down on strikes. Not sure about that call. Pitcher might have gotten a friendly strike three. So he gets the call and picks up the strikeout looking.
Sometimes with a good hitter at the plate, he'll be the one to get the benefit of the doubt if he lays off on a close pitch like that, but just not right there. Strike zone definitely expand a little bit with two strikes.
The batter now will be Will Smith. And that's a base hit. So a two-out knock keeps the inning alive. And Singy, as a team, you need to make the most of the very few opportunities he's going to give you, right?
Absolutely. And you know, if you don't get to guys like this, a lot of times early, once they really settle in, it's going to be the later innings that they hand that ball over to a reliever, if they do at all.
And now Teoscar Hernandez. There's a strike. Two gone, but the go-ahead run is at first. And we're just getting started here in the top of the first. Swings through it for the K. Couldn't catch up to the heater. So the Dodgers leave one, and now it's the Phillies' turn. No score. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. Back here in Philadelphia, towing the slab in today's game, Bobby Miller. Chris, how about a scouting report?
It's always interesting to see how he utilizes all of his pitches and how many of those he has a good feel for on that given day. When he's right, he's really able to keep hitters guessing, and all of his stuff seems to be coming out of the same arm slot, the same tunnel. And that can make life very difficult on his opponents.
We go to the bottom of the first. Kyle Schwarber comes up to hit here. Ball to strike, the pitch. Bounding ball here, rolls foul.
Good zip on that fastball at the bottom of the zone. If he's there all day, it's going to be a tough one for the hitters.
Righty delivers.
That's a ball. Two balls, two strikes.
There's a swing and a drive. And it bangs off the out-of-town scoreboard.
These guys today are so great at handling velocity. They're seeing high speeds day after day, and a nice job of turning that one around.
Trey Turner now. One on the gun, swing and a miss. Nobody out, runner at first. Next offering way off the plate. Base hit, throw back in quickly. First and second now with nobody out.
A couple of singles back to back. That's a good sound coming off the bat, man. And as he connected out front and looked into the outfield, that's one of those swings where you just don't even feel the ball hit the barrel. That's a poor stroke.
Here's Harper now. And a 1-1. And that one fouled off. Left-hand hitter waits. Rolled to short, possible two ball. Feed to second, that's one. Throw off line, he's safe. And a nice job there to keep it from getting away.
Well, they had the chance of turning two right there, but I don't think he got a good grip on the ball as he tried to transfer from glove to throwing hand. They say you can't assume a double play. I beg to differ at the big league level, but it's going to be ruled as a fielder's choice.
And now it's Alec Bohm. Two on, one out. That's in there. It's a ball and two strikes.
Well, all eyes on the double play ball in this spot. No better way to get out of this inning.
Some heat there at 98 miles an hour.
That was such a great opportunity to grab the lead. You had the infield bat. All you've got to do is just put the ball in play on the ground, and you drive across a run. It's a frustrating outcome for the hitter. Now, I'll still have a chance, but it's probably going to take a clutch hit with two outs.
This is Bryson Stott. The 1-1. Swings and lines a base hit into left field. And they'll score first. It's Munson. The throw is wild, and it gets away.
Well, there you go. The RBI machine. Another clutch run scoring at bat.
Yeah, he's been so good in these situations. Call it clutch if you want, but his resume speaks for itself. Nick Castellanos at the plate now. The pitch.
Well, lots of pitches thrown in this first inning. It's kind of that nightmare scenario for starting pitching, but you know what? It's still early enough. He can settle in. He can get some length if he just cleans up his mechanics a little bit.
Ground ball to go. That's a base hit. Rounds third, headed for the plate. The throw in. He'll score. It's 2-0.
Two consecutive base hits for this team. Once you get the ball by the pitcher, there's a lot of base hits up the middle, even on ground balls. So a nice job to use that big hole and get himself a hit.
Brandon Marsh steps to the plate. And a foul ball. Two on, two outs.
Ball two.
Tough start for him so far, already at 30 pitches here in the first.
Ribble.
Chase that time. David Dahl on deck for the Phils. And the righty deals. Battling here as he fouls it away. Here comes a 3-2. Cracks his bat and pops him up. Biggio brings it in for the third out. So it's two runs on four hits, no errors, and a couple left on. We move on to inning number two here in Philadelphia. It's the Phillies 2 and the Dodgers nothing. Top of the second, here's the rookie right fielder, Andy Pajes.
So after scoring runs, this is where you're looking for that shutdown inning. Get that hot team back in there to swing the bats.
In the dirt, and it's 2-2. Righty to the plate. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him.
Toughest pitch to hit. Fastball on the outer black. Man, sometimes you just got to tip your cap.
Here's Jason Hayward. Got him looking. Called strike three and a fastball up in the zone. Back-to-back strikeouts to start the frame, and that's now three in a row.
Yeah, he's really settling in and getting a feel for his pitches, throwing them where he wants to right now. So we'll see how long he can keep this streak going.
Two outs, bases empty. And up next for Los Angeles, Miguel Rojas. And now 2-2. Caught and missed. Struck him out. And the Dodgers are set down in order. Dodgers go down quietly, and they're down 2-0. Back here, Citizens Bank Park. Here's the left fielder, David Dahl.
David Dahl.
The Y to kick the pitch. Swing and a miss as he was late. Saying he wasn't very sharp in the first, got hit around a little bit, just wasn't able to locate particularly well. A lot of stuff for the fat part of the plate.
Yeah, Boog, he wasn't fooling anyone. It's a tough place to be because it's not always obvious what adjustments need to be made. Sometimes it's location. Sometimes it's being too predictable. Sometimes you're tipping your pitches. He's going to need to figure it out quickly, though.
Here's the catcher to hit, Garrett Stubbs. Just missed. One out, base is empty. That's in there, and the count is even, 2-2. Matthew Ross umpiring behind home plate for us in this one. He's got a reputation for having a bit of a wide strike zone, Chris.
Yeah, no doubt, Boog. He rewards pitchers when they're working the edges and sometimes a little bit beyond that. So for the hitters, just have to really be aware. Don't miss your pitch when you get it early in the count.
Outside, and that is ball four.
The batter.
So the Philly batting order turns over. Here's the Phillies DH, Kyle Schwarber.
This is a batter right here who really produces in these night games, and we saw the latest example of it in his first AB.
The bat going too soon, and strike two.
This guy's got such a good sinker. As a hitter, you've got to look up in the zone. If you look down, you're going to be chasing stuff in the dirt.
Stays alive.
Pretty good pitch there to take a rip at. He wants to get his arms extended. He likes the ball away from him a little bit, just not able to square it up.
That one a little bit high. The count now 2-2.
Well, he's not afraid to fall into a two-strike count. Knows the strike zone very well, so much so that I think umpires will look at him and determine whether it's a ball or strike, if he swings or not. Well, we see it a lot more these days than we ever did when I played, but a slider in the 90s still catches your attention. Even if you're sitting on the pitch, good luck recognizing that tight spin and adjusting to the late break.
Trey Turner with a chance now. The pitch. There's a strike. Got it by him for the K. One left for Philadelphia as they're unable to add to their 2-0 lead. Top half of the third inning, and at the plate for the Dodgers, Gavin Lux. The 1-1. That's inside. Bounce to the left side. Boom. Fires across the diamond and one away in the top of the third. Kevin Biggio up to the plate. Gosicki, this is a guy that grew up in big league clubhouses, and it's something that you see throughout the game. Sons whose fathers also played the majors. Next offering is fouled back.
I can only imagine the comfort level of being in the ballpark for those kids who are fortunate enough to have a dad that played in the big leagues. Then being on the baseball field, for some it's pressure. For them, they feel that they are right at home. I got to think that was the plan all the way. He set him up with a high fastball and then bury that curveball down low to get him swinging. Now, especially with how effective pitchers work up in the zone these days, that's a devastating combination. Instead of letting the hitter get his arms extended, tied him up a little bit, slightly up, slightly in.
Two down, nobody on. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Boog, do you think you could draw a walk in the bigs if we gave you enough at bats?
Ooh, that's a good question. I think that if they gave the pitcher a false scouting report on me, yes, I think I could draw a walk. Wheeler with a throw over. Ohtani back in. The Dodgers down by a pair. We're here in the top half of inning number three. Swing and a pop up. Foul territory for the catcher. Stones makes the grab, and that'll end the inning. No runs on no hits, no errors, and one left on base. We head down to the home half of inning number three. It's the Phillies 2 and the Dodgers nothing. Back at Citizens Bank Park, and now the first baseman, Bryce Harper.
Harper.
2-1 now. Bounced up the middle. Rojas with the throw to first. Harper retired.
Now batting, third baseman, Alec Boehm.
So now it's the four-hole hitter, Alec Boehm.
When he steps into the batter's box, the comfort level looks so high. It doesn't matter what kind of delivery that pitcher has, what kind of velocity, what kind of secondary stuff. He is so settled in there. He owns the home plate area.
And a curve is down and in. Though Chris, through the early stages, he hasn't been very efficient in terms of the pitch count. He's going to need to get some quick outs if he's going to get deeper into this game. Line drive, and that should be extra bases. Now he'll turn for second. And he's in with a stand-up double. It is interesting, though, when you consider the way the game is run now, doesn't even matter that much if your starter doesn't go that deep because teams are really aggressively building their bullpens. digging in for Philadelphia, Bryson Stott. And the right-hander deals. Foul ball there. One out and a runner at second here in the last half of the third. Up the middle, Rojas. Over to first, and he's out.
The right fielder, number 8, Nick.
Here's Nicholas Castellanos. Two outs. Swing and a miss at 100 miles an hour. Next offering is down low. Brandon Marsh next to bat for Philadelphia. Kicks and fires. The right-hander gives up the two-out walk.
Center field, number 16.
First and third, two away. And now the center fielder, Brandon Marsh. Siggy, he's got a history of coming through in the big spots. I know I like to talk about, I'm not sure whether clutch actually exists, but you look at the numbers, and this guy always seems to deliver in those spots. Two on, two outs. Bounce to the right side. Lux on to first. That ends the inning. Phillies leave a couple, but they hold the 2-0 lead. Back here in Philadelphia, out of the fourth, and up to the plate is Will Smith. Next offering misses. Now two balls and a strike.
You know, these Dodgers just haven't produced as many competitive at-bats as I'd like to see in this one. They've gone down on strikes at a high rate today, so it's probably time to simplify the approach and just find ways to put the ball in play.
Swing and a miss, and the count's full.
Three balls.
It's a leadoff walk for Will Smith.
That could jumpstart an offense that's really struggled to score in this one. Don't want to wake a team up with a free pass.
Here's Teoscar Hernandez. The 2-1. Foul off down the right side. Finish him off.
By the start to this game on the mound, looking very dangerous to these hitters. 7 punchouts already, so this lineup hasn't had much success trying to figure him out. I'm impressed with what we're seeing here.
Andy Pajes steps to the plate for the Dodgers. The 1-1 is fouled off. In the dirt, 2-2. The pitch.
That's the ball. Three balls. Two strikes.
Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. In the air, left field, down the line. Dahl settles underneath it. Dahl makes the catch.
Now the seventh fielder, Jason Hayward.
Now, Jason Hayward. Next offering in there for a strike. That's strike two.
They can live up in the zone all game if hitters will chase it. That's just too much velocity. Hitters got to look down in the zone.
Kicks and deals. That one lifted to left. Gets under it. Makes the catch. And that is that. One left for LA. They trail things here 2-0. And welcome back to the ballpark. Bottom four, and now for the Phillies, David Dahl. Here's a 1-1. And that's downed away. First signs of bullpen movement here in the early going. Landon Knack looks to be getting ready for manager Dave Roberts. Knack also throwing. The wind and the pitch. Fouls one off. 2-2. And a pitch. Good eye right there.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Got him looking, and he did not like the call.
Frustrating end to the at bat for the hitter, and I'm sure that's going to sit on for a little while. You want to be ready to hit the fastball. Sometimes you can overthink things, and I think that was the case right there.
Next offering upstairs.
Love coming to Citizens Bank Park. Best ice cream in all of the league at the press level. It's only been around since 2004, but plenty of awesome history here already. It's the only stadium with multiple postseason no-hitters. Remember Roy Halladay did it back in 2010? And the Houston Astros threw a combined no-no in Game 4 of the 2022 World Series.
Back to the top of the lineup. And the batter now, Kyle Schwarber. Two down, nobody on. We're here in the bottom of the fourth. Next offering upstairs.
Way to lay off that fastball up right there. You're looking for something you see well that you can handle, but you also have to keep the discipline so that you're not popping up pitches that are just a little too high.
Throw on to Freeman. Schwarber out of the play. And the Phillies are set down in order. Phillies go down quietly in the inning, but they're on top 2-0. Back here in Philadelphia, top five, John Schottky with Chris Singleton. And leading it off, Miguel Rojas. Close one, doesn't get the call. 2-1.
You know, these Dodgers showing great discipline at the plate, and patience definitely seems to be the name of their game in this one. Starter's leash has to be getting tighter with his pitch count where it is, but so far he's been really effective in this one.
High fly ball out to left field. Dahl hauls it in, and there's one away.
You know, sometimes it just takes getting to the bullpen in order to be able to score runs, and that might be the case today.
And now it's Gavin Lux. Base is empty, one away, and we're at the top of the fifth. And another ball.
Two balls, one strike.
Wouldn't chase that time.
Three and one.
Swing and a miss as he was out front. Goes down swinging for the strikeout. He swung over top of the curveball.
Got away with that curveball, no doubt about it. It passed right through the heart of the strike zone, and he just couldn't get the bat on it. When you strike out on one like that, that's when you start having conversations with yourself, and they're not usually very friendly.
So two down now, and here is Kevin Biggio. Fly ball to right. Castellanos gets under it. And he makes the catch. And that'll do it. So they turn things over to the righty, Landon Knack.
Well, at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings. And you need a little length out of this arm. Coming out of the bullpen, we'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
Here's Turner now.
For the Phillies, the shortstop.
Turner.
And now 2-1. And that one fouled off. Comes a 2-2. Struck him out looking. Fastball at the letters, frozen for strike three. And now here is Harper. Let's go. 1-1 now. 1-1 missing inside. So now 2-1 to Harper. Two now. That's foul off to the right side. Keeps the AB going. On the ground. Lux tosses to first. Harper retired.
Now back. The third baseman,
Alec
Boehm.
Next to hit, Alec Boehm. Two down, nobody on. Swing and a miss, and it's 1-2.
Clearly he was sitting on a fastball right there. It just ended up out in front of the slider. Hey, you can't fault him for his commitment. Now he's just going to have to battle with two strikes.
And a miss struck him out. Three up, three down for Philadelphia. They're up 2-0. All right, we go to the top half of inning number six. Now it's the Dodger leadoff hitter, Shohei Ohtani. Next offering down low and in the dirt.
Looking to get something going. This is the guy you want at the plate. He's been great for this team. He is a professional hitter.
That one to first. Boots it. To first. Boom. And he just gets it there in time. One away. Here comes Freddie Freeman up to hit. And a pitch. Next offering is outside. And there's a foul ball. Swing and a ball lifted to center field. March makes the grab, and there's two gone.
And he's close as he's trying to get through six full innings right now. He's about to throw his 100th pitch. I'd be surprised if this isn't it for him.
Will Smith will hit next. The Dodgers trailing by two, and we're the top half of the sixth. That misses the zone, and that's ball two. And another ball. Teoscar Hernandez waiting for a turn at the plate. And the pitch. Swing and a miss. As he was out front that time. Waves at the defender for the strikeout. Make it six shutout innings for him out there now. It's the Phillies two and the Dodgers nothing. And we're back. Going up bottom six. And stepping in is the speedy Bryson Stott. 1-1. And a swing and a miss. 1-2. And there's a ball. Wouldn't chase that time. And he deals. And that's ball four.
Thank you, mate.
Leading up for the Phillies.
Man at first. And now the right fielder, Nick Castellanos.
He might want to steal second in this spot, but he's dealing with a catcher that has one of the best pop times in the game. He needs to pick his spot very wisely.
Runner at first with no outs here. Next pitch misses way outside. Fouls it back with two strikes.
Flew open a little bit with that front shoulder, but was able to slow his bat down just enough to make contact with that pitch, keep the bat alive.
Swing and a pop up in foul ground. Biggio drifts towards it. Makes the catch for the out.
That was a good pitch to hit right down the heart of the plate. Had pretty good timing on it. Just got underneath it a little bit and popped it up.
Brandon March stands in for the Phillies. Right-handed reliever. Fouled off. He was late. The kick and the pitch. Runner goes. Gets a piece and stays alive. And that just misses.
It's a good take.
off the mark there. And that's ball three.
So here we go. Base runner at first. Could be running on the pitch. He's got good enough speed to steal the bag and get in scoring position, even if it's a swing and miss at the plate. You get a walk, and you get a walk. Everyone gets a walk.
So first and second with one gone. Now the left fielder, David Dahl. The Phillies trying to break this one open here in the bottom of the sixth. And that'll load the bases.
Well, the stage has been set for this offense, Boo. It's all about creating opportunities, and this is one of them right here.
So digging in now for Philadelphia, Garrett Stubbs. The 1-1. Here's a rocket out to left. He's got it. Runner tags for home. To the plate. And save. And they lead by three.
Sometimes that can be a little tough to score on. It was hit so hard that getting back to the bag, the tag, takes a little bit of time by the time that outfielder catches it. A really good job of getting that run in from third.
So the batting order turns over. Kyle Schwarber stands in for the Phillies. Gets the slider in there for a strike. Two outs. Couple of base runners at first and second. Hard grounder into the outfield for a knock. Around third. Fires it to the plate. It's offline. The run comes in, and it's 4-0.
What an aggressive secondary lead. That ball was smoked to left. Be able to score from second. Not only great speed, but great instinct as well.
So two on with two away. Here's Trey Turner. Ground ball left side. They take the force out. That ends the inning and stops things from getting out of hand. They put two on the board. One hit, no errors, but two are left stranded. We're through six full. It's the Phillies 4 and the Dodgers nothing. New inning getting started. Now it's the Dodger cleanup hitter, Teoscar Hernandez. And that one in the air center field, moving under it. And it's caught for the out.
Up next for the Dodgers.
And next for L.A., Andy Pajes. The Dodgers down by four here in the top half of inning number 7. Next offering upstairs. And another ball. And there's a strike.
Okay.
Outside, and that is ball four.
Pitch count's getting up there now, and not saying that's the reason for this walk, but this is the point in the game when every sign of wavering starts to get everyone's attention.
In the air, right field. Sizes this one up. That's out number two.
Maybe caught that one off the end just a little bit. Couldn't quite barrel it up enough to really drive it.
Man at first, Miguel Rojas at the plate.
Shortstop, Miguel Rojas.
The 2-1. And a strike. Activity in the bullpen. Matt Strom, the left-hander, is getting that big fastball of his ready to go. Kirkering warming up as well. Two outs. Out to short. Turner. They get the force. That's the third out. So the Dodgers leave one. They trail it here 4-0. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Bryce Harper to the plate. And another ball.
You know, these Phils, digging into their numbers, have to be happy with the swings they're taking. They've hit 7 line drives already, and even though some of them have been for outs, there's nothing wrong with delivering consistent hard contact. That's almost always going to lead to positive results.
And it's even up. The other way, and he beats the shift. So a runner aboard to start the inning.
Well, patience and discipline paid off right there as he got into an advantage count. Good piece of hitting going the other way with that pitch to beat the shift. You know, not a lot of guys are willing to do that, even with the shift on, because they're looking to pull the ball with authority. But it's a pretty easy hit if you want it.
Got him. One gone here.
He's locked in at the plate when he's using the whole field. He was out in front there. Just needs to let the ball travel a little more, and his timing will be back on track. Good pitch for the strikeout.
And a 1-1. Late swing, foul to the left. Keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball. The pitch. Whoa. And that's downstairs and outside.
Good miss with that changeup away. He needs a ball on the ground for a double play. Minimize the potential threat right here. On the hitter's side, nice job of laying off that pitch.
Hit hard. That gets through. They fired in quickly. So it's first and second with only one away.
Couldn't have timed it up any better than that. Couldn't get any air under it, but he smoked that ball back up the middle.
So the Dodgers have a new arm on the mound, Anthony Banda.
Anthony Banda.
Now it's the right fielder, Nick Castellanos. At the belt and fires. That's off the mark, and it's 2-1.
Tough spot right here, a couple runners on. 2-ball count. You can't nibble, but you have to execute and finish your pitch. If you leave something out over the plate, it's going to bring in some runs.
And now the lefty. Fastball for a strike. Hard grounder into the outfield for a nod. Here comes Harper around third. Throw is offline and he scores. And the lead is up to 5.
He was all over that one. I really like that swing, man. He didn't just push it the other way through the infield. He drove it that way. And it kind of makes me think he was thinking opposite field as he stepped into the box. Got a pitch he liked and he got it done.
First and second, one out. Brandon Marsh stands in for the Phillies. Popped up, foul territory behind the plate. Smith hauls it in, 2 away.
The left fielder, number 31, David Dahl.
And digging in for Philadelphia, David Dahl. Two on, two outs. Fouls it off, still 1-2. Left-hand batter waits. Foul ball still, 1-2 count. Left-hand hitter waits. And down on strikes he goes. And that'll keep more runs from coming in, inning over. But the RBI single pushes across a run. And the lead is now 5-0. You're watching Major League Baseball exclusively on the show. Back at Citizens Bank Park, we're at the top of the eighth. And now here is Gavin Lux. Here's a 1-1. Swings through that one.
Just an outstanding job of spinning the baseball, moving it around, doing what he does.
Got him swinging for the strikeout. Had him out front for strike three.
Well, when you swing through that one breaking ball that puts you up against the ropes for two strikes, you think he's either going to double up or try to blow a fastball by you with the next pitch. Right there, he snapped off another curve. It was the same result as the pitch before.
And a swing and a miss there. And here it comes. Swung on, belted. Castellanos ranges back. Out of here. And they've got their first run. It's 5-1.
That gives this offense something to celebrate for the first time in this one. Well, I'm sure there's a big grin on his face right now, Boo. He's probably had some of those that didn't stay fair, but off the bat, it looked like it was going to bend foul. He was able to keep it in there, tucked it nicely, and he gets the jog around the bases. Good for him.
Manager out of the dugout now, and it looks like we'll see a change on the mound. Zach Wheeler won't go any further, and we'll be back with their first arm out of the pen after a quick break. Well, new pitcher will be the lefty, Matt Strom.
And he's got a nice lead to work with, so he should come in throwing strikes, attacking these hitters.
Back to the top of the Dodgers order. Shohei Ohtani up to the dish. Pitch. That's outside. It's 2-2.
The guy at the plate could recognize slider out of the hand. Didn't stay in the tunnel very long in terms of depth and perception. He knew right away it was an off-speed pitch.
One down, base is empty. Swings and misses, struck him out.
The first base is number 5.
Freddie Freeman up to the dish. Pitch. Movement in the bullpen, Sir Anthony Dominguez. The hard throwing righty is up and loosening. And he chases that one. That's out number 3. Solo shot for the Dodgers this inning. It's now a 5-1 ball game. It's Major League Baseball on the show. Back here, Citizens Leading Bank Park. And now it's going to be Garrett Stubbs. The lefty fires. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. And that's in the dirt. Right through there, got him. Leadoff man is out here in the eighth.
Man, he had the stanky leg on that one right there. That curveball just locked him up. Kyle.
So the lineup flips over. Now it's going to be Kyle Schwarber.
With this kind of lead, he can swing freely, try to hit the ball out of the park, do what he loves to do.
Here comes a pinch.
Nope, off it.
That one called just inside, I think, and on the mound, he's trying to get a little bit of an explanation. Doesn't seem to be too bothered by it, though, but he clearly thought it clipped the corner.
And there's a fly ball deep right field. And it one hops the wall. The throw into second. It's a double. Third hit of the night for him.
Nice line drive to the pull side. Met it out front, but just stayed through it nice enough and ripped it into the outfield.
Runner at second. Now the number two hitter, Trey Turner. Kicks and deals. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Man at second. Not even close there. And the count's even at 2. The pitch. Swings and misses. It's a strikeout. Couldn't catch up to the heater. Here's Bryce Harper.
First base hit number 3. Harper.
Runner at second, 2 down. Here the bottom half of the 8th inning. Next offering in there for a strike. And that is strike 2. Swing and a miss, and that's that. Phillies strand one. They lead this one, though, 5-1. We go to the ninth. Here's the catcher, Will Smith.
Will Smith.
Hard on the ground to first. Harper takes it to the bag, and the leadoff man retired here in the ninth.
Now that the left hander, Teoscar Hernandez.
And next will be the Dodgers cleanup hitter, Teoscar Hernandez. The Phils leading by 4 here at the top of the ninth. There's a strike. Kicks and fires. That one just misses. 2-2.
Close pitch there, and he's kind of wondering where it missed. You know, getting a feel for each umpire's strike zone is something that pitchers and hitters really have to think about and work on from game to game and sometimes from at bat to at bat.
And he deals. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. Careful. And that one upstairs. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk. It wasn't easy, but he earned that walk after a long at bat.
It's tough after falling behind a hitter, 2 balls and no strikes, but now at least he gets a fresh start against a new batter. But he needs to get back into the strike zone and start pitching with conviction.
On the ground a second, might be two. Looks for one, but safe at first. It's a fielder's choice. So last chance for the Dodgers. Here's the center fielder, Jason Hayward. Two outs. They're down to their final strike. One strike away.
Whether you're a season ticket holder or you just come to a couple of games a year, to see your team win at home, there's just something special about that. Good job by this team to get it done for the hometown fans.
5-1 is how it ends. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew here at MLB The Show, thanks for stopping by. I'm John Ciambi. Talk to you soon.
First for the victorious Philadelphia Phillies, 5 runs, 10 hits, no errors. They left 10 runners on base.